I have CBP 75.1. I have the entry summary. How much should I include on that entry summary? What amount of shipment? One container, two containers? Can I include 100 containers? Can I include 1,000 containers? Is there an end? Can I just, you know, those big container ships? Can I just clear the whole big container ship under one entry? And why would I want to do that? Or more importantly, why would I not want to do that? What are the limitations? So those are the very life issues which happen every day, because they deal, for example, with line items for each shipment which has its own HTS. You have a line item, and many customs brokers, they charge money by the line item, and among other things, they have certain billing. But this is one of the criteria by which they bill, many, at least many. Another situation is the block 39. Block 39 establishes the payment of fees. And there is something which is called harbor maintenance fee. HMF. There is a merchandise processing fee. And regulations tell us that the maximum fee for processing merchandise is $485. Must not exceed $485. So the idea is how many? And the general rule says one conveyance consigned to one consignee must be included in one entry. One conveyance to one consignee. One conveyance to one consignee. What's one conveyance? Usually, if you have a bill of lading, you'll have listing of containers here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 4 containers on one bill of lading going to my warehouse. That's one consignee, my warehouse, one conveyance. So I can include all 4 on one entry. Probably know that you cannot put it on one ship. It's huge. So see, this is a small tugboat, and they're probably big too. But the point being is, you have those parts that are separate. You have, for example, this is a helideck with a helicopter lens. It comes in separately. You have cranes. They come in separate. You have many parts. It's a huge structure. But because we live in an economy which is based on energy, this stuff comes in all the time, right? Especially when offshore oil exploration reaches its peak. So this would be the second situation. When you bring in something from from outside of the United States. And if you really look at the industry, a lot of stuff are being made outside of the United States. So, for example, I believe Korea, South Korea, is the leading designer of the major part of the platform, of the skeleton. Wow, look at this one. Different classes of merchandise processed by different customs, commodity specialist teams. What's that? So customs has its own pecking order. Customs have teams called entry specialist team. Entry specialist or import. And import, not all. Specialist. Team, let's say 361, just for example. And they have their own numbers for depending on the port, whatever. And those guys, all they do is milk. Team 275, all they do is computers. All right, there. Let's take Los Angeles. Does anyone see this team breakdown? So you have entry specialist team 1, entry specialist team 2, entry specialist team 3. All they do is their communities. They're broken down to communities. And if you... So that's import specialist, entry specialist. Entry specialist is usually first line. They do the entries. Import specialists, they are the ones who analyze communities. So if you have import specialists, they usually deal only with their communities. So we have a port of Los Angeles, California. This is a phone number for the entry specialist team 710. And all they do is animal, vegetable products, residue waste from food industry, products of American fisheries. So if you have a question about fish, and you call up these guys, they will probably put you on hold and send you over to the team that does fisheries, right? But see, team 720, they are not only specializing in wearing apparel, they specialize in wearing apparel from China and Hong Kong. So you have that level of specialty within customs. All they do is China and Hong Kong wearing apparel. They come in, they start, they analyze apparel from China and Hong Kong. If it comes from Indonesia, it goes somewhere else. It goes probably to these guys. Although I'm not even sure. Shiny countries, yeah, Indonesia, right? So as you see, this is the level of specialization can be pretty deep. So if I have one container, or let's say two containers coming with origin from China, and other two containers on the same shipment because of transshipment, they come from, let's say, New Zealand, let's say wool. It's maybe reasonable for me to say, look, can I make those two containers under entry for team 721 and the other one for team 720? The hold all situation where you wait for all merchandise to arrive. Remember, it must arrive one within 10 calendar days. Calendar days is the most strict requirement because it accounts for holidays. So it's where business days would be like 14 calendar days. Calendar days is much smaller window. So there is after arrival of merchandise, yeah, there is just after arrival, I think here that's good. And the here you are not looking for the release, so you still use form 3461. And you can file the 3461 as all portions of the shipment have arrived. So pretty much everything has arrived. You file 3461, and then you... be mindful of the timeline here, right? So this is 10 calendar days. This is when all stuff have to come to the United States. And you file 3461 at this moment, 3461, and then you have 10 working days or business days. To file 7501, And of course, with 7501, this is the time when you pay duties. Incremental release can mean two things. Incremental release procedure is available for two situations. Going back to the very beginning of the outline. Yeah. Split shipment and unassembled and disassembled entity. So thank you for asking this, because we need to talk about this one now. I'm finished with split shipment. Alright? I think, well, we shall see this. Remember, the 3461 can be used as both special permit for immediate delivery or entry, right? 10-day rule still applicable, irrespective of either. So you see this, think 10 working days, right? Or sometimes customs calls it business days. So I think that's one more thing to say. So since we got the split shipment, now we can talk about applicability of hold all procedure or incremental release procedure in the context of such things as big offshore oil rig. When can you file 3461? That are different. With 17501. This is the goal. And the title says this is all about entry summary. So we're moving away from 3461 entry. We're talking about entry summary, CBP form 7501. So let's look at the general rule. So port director can consolidate, can permit the consolidation of separate entries on one entry summary. So you have entry 1 and entry 2. You would like to put them on the same entry summary. Why would you want to do that? Well, for one example, it goes back to the same thing we discussed before, $485 ceiling. Right? You have merchandise processing fee which cannot exceed $485. If you process them separately, if you have two 7501s for each, then let's say you have to pay $485, then you pay $485. But here, you only pay $485.